In today's video, we are going to explore which image compression tool will be the best option to have to optimize images on your WordPress website.
Hi guys, this is Booly. Today I am going to show you guys how to optimize images in your WordPress website to keep your site light and have a very fast performance. All right, let's get to it.
All right, we have three simple hacks or options in this video. Number one, use TinyPNG. Number two, use Photoshop. Number three, use the Smooch plugin. So let's get started with TinyPNG first. Let's go to our demo website. Let's check on the plugins. All right, we have only four plugins so far, so the site is not that heavy. This is usually the most basic WooCommerce theme that I just installed. So let's check out AdKingdom. Let's see how fast the basic WooCommerce theme will run. All right, it takes about 1.05 seconds to load with the page size 1.6 megabytes. So let's go to tinypng.com to compress a picture and upload it to our website. The image right here that I already prepared, this image is quite very huge that we're gonna add to a new blog. And let's drag this picture over here for TinyPNG to compress. All right, it compressed about 56%. So let's download the image here. All right, we got the picture from TinyPNG. That's the image that we just got from TinyPNG. So it reduced the size of the image, the original image, to 1.72 megabytes, but the width and the height are still the same. All right, let's go back to our demo website to upload this picture to our new blog. Click post to create a new blog. Click add new on the top of the page to create a new blog. Let's close that out and add your title right here. I'm gonna add whatever. Maybe the blue sky for now. It's just like a testing blog. And I'm gonna add a dummy text right here. And there you go. This is my new blog. And click the publish button on the top right. And I'm gonna add the picture from TinyPNG right here in the middle of the page. Click the plus sign to add an image and click the upload button right here to upload the picture from TinyPNG that we just did earlier. Let's change this image to cover or something like that. Let's see how it's gonna look like. Okay, it looks all right. Let's click the update button right there. All right, let's get out of here for now. And let's go to the front end to refresh the page to see all the updates. Okay, it looks good. Let's go to tool.pingdom.com to test this out. The test location is based in San Francisco. All right, it takes about 1.03 seconds to load the website, but the page size is 1.6 megabytes. The next option is using Photoshop to compress images. All right, let's go back to the demo website again to get rid of or remove all the picture from TinyPNG from earlier test. Let's upload a new picture from Photoshop this time. That's the original picture that we are going to use to edit in the Photoshop. If you already have Photoshop installed, you should be able to right-click on that picture to open it in the Photoshop. Click image on the top of the page. Just change this to 2 pixels. And then you could type the width and then the height will be changed automatically for you. Let's see, let's change to 800 pixels. And then it just changed the height for us to 516 pixels. Once everything looks good, just click OK. And then go to File. Hover over Export, click Save for Web Legacy. As you can see right now, this picture is in the JPEG format with high resolution, and the picture doesn't look that bad at all from the preview window right here. It still has good quality. So if you change the picture resolution to be higher, you will add more load time. As long as the quality of the picture is not lost, you should be able to change it back to high. Then the picture size will be smaller and the load time will be less too. As you could see, more information right there. All right, once everything looks good, just click the save button. We are going to save to the downloads folder or directory right here. I'm gonna name it, add something Photoshop in it so that I know which file for what test, and then click the save button right here. All right, we got the picture to upload now. Let's upload it to our media library to use in the blog. That's the picture right up there, and click open right here to upload it to the media library. All right, let's go to posts. Click posts. Click the title of my blog right here. We are going to add this picture right in the middle of the blog. Click the plus sign or the add sign and click image, and then click the media library up there. And that's the information that we resized and compressed this picture a lot smaller. Click the select button and it looks good. Click the update button right here. Let's go to the front end to refresh the page to see the update. All right, it's there. It's time to go to Pingdom. Add your website, select the test from location, and click the start test button. All right, it takes about 1.04 seconds to load with the page size of 69 kilobytes for Photoshop here, with the performance grade of 94. And the last option in this video is to use the Smooch plugin to take care of the images. All right, I just removed the previous picture from the Photoshop, getting ready to test the Smoochit plugin. Go to plugins, click add new on top of the page, type Smooch. You should be able to see the search result right here. That's the plugin that we are going to install and use. Click the install now, and then click the activate button. And click the settings of the Smooch plugin right here. Let's go through a quick setup right here. Just leave it enabled and click next. Leave this option enabled and click next. It's okay to leave this enable as default and then click next. Just leave this lazy load as default and click finish setup wizard. And let's scroll down a little bit more. In the settings right here, we want to enable a few more options like this one. Resize original images. And then scroll down a little bit more to enable compress original images. Leave the rest of the settings the same and then click the save changes button at the bottom right. Let's go to the media library to upload this picture to our media library to use in our blog. Select files. Select that image. Yep, that's the image for the Smoochit. Use the original one as big as it is. And then click the open button right here to upload it. All right, the upload is done. Let's go to the posts. Click that blog. We are going to add that image right here again in the middle of the blog. Just click the media library right here to add the picture to the blog. As you could see, the Smoochit plugin did its job quite very well. It smooched the picture to 624 kilobytes and it's also resized it too. You could see more information right here too, and then click the select button and click the update button on the top right. It's done. Let's go to the front end to refresh the page to see the update. All right, It looks good. Let's go to Pingdom. Click the start test. We use San Francisco based test location again. All right, it looks like it takes about 1.02 seconds with the page size 69 kilobytes. That is not bad at all. And the performance grade is about 94, or the grade A. Not bad at all. Let's take a look at the final results again. We use the test location requesting the demo website from San Francisco. We did it right around 9:30 a.m. to 10:30 a.m. Eastern Standard Time on a Thursday in November. It looks like Tiny PNG does a good job too, but the page size is still too big though versus Photoshop and Smooch. However, you have to resize and compress the picture in Photoshop manually, but at the same time, the Smooch plugin does that for you automatically. Photoshop and Smooch turn out to have the same page size, but Smooch takes a little less time to load the website. But be aware, Smooch keeps a copy of your original pictures in your server though. Over time, your website can become large that you need to go to remove the original images in the file system in your server manually. If you don't do that, your website will become very, very slow. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe. Have a wonderful day wherever you are. I'll see you in my next video. Bye.